This is Fabulae 21, 3 to 4. Mox ferum vidit. Soon he saw the beast. There's your V, there's your DL. And then Arcum. Now, we've got a relative clause in here. That's the relative pronoun. Okay, so that's a bracket there, that's a chunk. And this direct object goes with this big V here, this verb. And he drew his bow, which he had brought with him. This is one of those flip-flop dealies. It's really cum se with him. Now this relative pronoun, it refers to the arcum. So that is the antecedent, and it's the direct object in its own clause, which he had brought. So it's accusative. However, it is referring to arcum, so it is singular and masculine. That's how relative pronouns work. Eistam in pelum, quae densissima erat. Ooh, here's another relative. This is like a whole lesson on the relative pronoun. And here's your main verb here. He could not, and then this is the infinitive, triicere, could not pierce his hide, however, which was very dense. So this quai is referring to the pelem here. It's feminine, feminine, singular, singular. In its own clause, it's the subject of erat. And so it's nominative, even though this is accusative. All right, then, clava magna, with a great club, ablative of means, which, relative clause again. He always brought with him, percussit leonem. He struck the lion. There's your verb, your direct object. Here is the relative clause. Quam refers to the clava. So feminine, feminine, singular, singular. And it's the direct object of the verb gerebat. So by function, it's accusative, even though its antecedent is ablative. Frustra tamen. In vain, however, neque enum hoc modo eam occidere potuit. For he could not, now this negative goes with the potuit here, he could not occidere, kill him. Infinitive again, with this potuit, just like up here, potuit, which is the main verb.